The weapons in Mockingjay, it's the next generation of weapons that we've seen, the progression of them in these films. And Drew Petrada and his prop department are amazing. The people they have working for them, not only in the design, but in the building of practical weapons that the stunt department can use. And it's all grounded in what Francis really pushed for, is grounded in the world, in kind of a real world feel.
The previous movies were more about almost gladiator style, but these ones get almost into modern warfare. We went back and forth several times about which way to go. He didn't want anything to look like absolute present day, like US military or British military or something we knew what it was. We wanted to go a little bit further back in time for the most part. And so we went to a lot of World War II weapons for our rebels. And our main heroes used a bit more modern weapon.
It's for you. Plutarch wanted you to have a weapon for the sake of the propos, but he couldn't just make you a fashion accessory.
It's beautiful.
This is Katniss's Mockingjay bow. We went through a lot of discussions about which way to go with the bow. Although in the book, BD makes her a very high-tech bow, they wanted to go back to more of the classic image. So we used a lot of practical off-the-shelf bows to discover a shape that we liked. And this bow is a combination of about four different bows, believe it or not. And then into color and texture, and we have some, it fades into blue, which ties into the Mockingjay costume. It was mostly a paint detail after that. Studio Art and Technology painters came up with this idea a few movies ago with me, and it's stretching a net across a base color and putting a second color over the top of it, and it appears to be like a honeycomb finish. And then there's some pearlescent in there, so it changes with the light. And same in here, the fade changes a bit with the light, so it's very subtle.
Regular, incendiary, explosive arrows, all color-coded. And tell Finnick, got a trident for him when he's ready.
This is Finnick's new trident. This is the trident BD made for Finnick. One of the things that we wanted to do is, because of the amount of action that are in this movie and that they're military and running around, that it be a little bit more compact. So for ease of carry, and made a little bit more sense. But it also has the ability to expand digitally into the same size of the trident he used in Catching Fire. One of the cool things about this trident is that we struggled really hard with designing the trident. We made probably, hundreds of illustrations trying to come up with something that was different than Catching Fire, something that looked like BD could make, and did something special. So this one also expands and opens to change the shape quite a bit. And it's a nasty looking weapon. And we got this design of the mechanics of this based on arrow tips. There's some hunting arrow tips that, when pressed in here, open up. But we're pretty proud of this. We like this one a lot.
Maybe you want to try one out. If you can be a part of Katniss Propo team, you may as well look the part.
This is the crossbow that BD made for Gale. It started with the base of an actual crossbow. They wanted it to look very military, but then it had to fire these different kind of bolts.
Gale's crossbow was a very interesting piece for discussion. You know, Katniss has her bow, which we established in the second film. She can fire multiple arrows kind of as quick as she can draw them, she can fire. Then you've got a crossbow, which traditionally you can shoot one, and then you have to draw the string back, put a bolt in. It takes time. So we're kind of in the early stages a bit concerned with Gale keeping up with the pace of action that we wanted. So we kind of did a bit of a cheat, if you will.
3, 2, 1, fire!
It's an automatic crossbow. So it has a barrel underneath the crossbow, which where all the arrows are held. And basically they cycle through like a gun almost, but it's a crossbow, which doesn't exist right now.
The package here with the auto-loading bolts was a really quick design. That was within about a day. The concept came through one day, and we had a design the next day and built and shooting 3 days later.
It's like geese, right?